when people are talking about the fourth industrial revolution today, they are mixing fourth industrial revolution with the digital economy. The digital economy is one consequence of the fourth industrial revolution, and also the new climate economy, which includes bio, hydrogen, carbon, methanol, and so on. They are part of this fourth industrial revolution. So when you start talking about skills, the first thing is to understand what you want to achieve.
And what we're observing is that there's a lot of appetite, a lot of hunger for good content on the African continent. And this is precisely what Foresight Africa tries to do.
Discussion of Foresight Africa is very important. The problem is a lot of discussions happen and the media does not help this. People do not understand how innovation is done or financed or how it can create jobs. And the public does not understand this. And so we are creating reports, and it's very good, but there is no understanding at a public level what this actually means.
The way we are thinking about that at the Next Sunshine Forum is to really build the framework for knowledge first creation. How do you create the pipeline to knowledge creation? How do you make sure that there is enough young people going in that pipeline? The first thing, of course, is the physical infrastructure. But the physical infrastructure is something that we should be really thinking how it will look like in 10 years from now. And this is really is really key. And then there is the digital infrastructure. But it goes beyond that. We have infrastructure that are specific to the type of economy we want to implement. So if in 10 years or 15 years from now, we have to drive cars with hydrogen, do we have that type of infrastructure? So do we have the capacity to design innovative policies for this type of new technology? Do we have the capacity to design innovative financial instruments to make sure that we can mobilize 10 billion USD per value chain? And then the human capital development, which goes beyond beyond digital skills. It's really having the right skills at all the level of this pipeline. And then the last aspect is how do we build partnership?
The view of people on Africa is that actually over the past decade, we have experienced so much bad governance that they see like the very first priority should be good governance and inclusion. I think the problem is not debt, it's the way you manage debt. What do you use debt for? Debt is actually very good as long as you are able to invest it the right way. So what we do here in Rwanda, the policy is we take debt when we have a project to finance. And a project that can mobilize resources to pay for the debt.
I think here we have to clarify a few things. I think we are talking about project financing. And actually, when we talk about innovation, we have to think about global value chain or value chain financing. And to me, there is no single country that can finance a value chain. And this is very different because the amount of money that we need to mobilize when we go from a project to a value chain, it's really huge. For a value chain, we are talking about billions of funding that we will need. And I think the type of instrument that we'll need in that type of situation are completely different. We need to think about, at Pan-African level, we need to think about public-private partnership that involve a consortium of industries with a consortium of governments. This is how you can really mobilize $1 billion to finance global value chain. At project level, we can think in terms of taxation mechanisms, debt, and these type of things. So we need to make the distinction between the two.
So one of the charts we show in Foresight edition is the mismatch between the young people who are skilled, what their aspiration is in terms of jobs and their capability versus the job they end up in. And you can see that there's a huge gap between what they can do, what they aspire to do, but what they are able to do, because that's just the jobs that are available.
One of the things I noticed in Foresight Africa is that we talk about taxes, profit shifting, but we actually don't talk about how much, if we align this framework, what kind of money can come out of these new industries that will be created in the climate, the new climate economies, the hydrogen economy, all these things, because we actually have not done an assessment internally.
So one of the things I saw in one of the viewpoint about the future of security, I think we're forgetting about how globalization has also affected this. So we're talking about climate change affecting migration, etc., but we are forgetting that cybersecurity is also going to be a very big threat. So how is government thinking about protecting their citizens? But also we look at terrorism. This is something that can be easily nurtured online, remotely, and you create violence in these different countries. So on a continent where, one, we don't have data, we're being blinded by the fact that we want to have internet penetration, mobile phones to everyone, but we are not thinking about what does protection mean to each and every citizen that is going online.
So there is a need to have a harmonized approach to cybersecurity on the continent, not only at national level, but at Pan-African level.
In order to achieve the SDGs, SDG 17 is very important, partnerships, and changing mindset, thinking that we are able when it comes to domestic resource mobilization to finance our growth.
We have to take the vision beyond the vision, so we have to identify the gaps and we have to put in place a joint action plan to actually achieve and leverage from the fourth industrial revolution.
I was saying at some point in time, all must benefit, but all must also contribute. At the end of the day, leaving no one behind is not only a requirement of the SDGs, but I think it's the number one strategy if you want to achieve that.
What's important now is to learn how to learn, because you're going to continue learning in the nature of jobs. Because there are some jobs today that will disappear tomorrow. Are you ready for the new jobs that are going to come? If you learn how to learn, and then there are institutions that are ready to help you learn the skills of the jobs of tomorrow, that's going to facilitate the transition and keep you employed.